Despite decades of searching distant planets and stars for alien life, we're still empty-handed. Turns out, we may have been looking in all the wrong places, and the answers could actually be much closer than we thought. Life could actually be right next door, floating on the lower clouds of Venus. Venus has some mysterious dark patches that might be swarms of alien microorganisms. Scientists have known about these patches for nearly a century. They first gained attention because they change shape so often, morphing from small patches to giant blobs over a matter of days. It looks kind of like a lava lamp.
You take a lava lamp and it's fully warmed up, these patches, these blobs are all floating around, and they change shapes, they get long, they get short, then they break up, they come back together. It's sort of like that. At least to me it seems like that, what the Venus clouds look like.
For decades, no one could come up with a convincing explanation of what was really going on. Then, in 1967, famed astronomer Carl Sagan suggested that the clouds could support alien life. And now, a team of scientists have new evidence to back this idea.
That there are these big patches, because they're three-dimensional, but they're hard to see in three dimensions, and they just move around. And so I think if you were inside the ocean, per se, like our ocean, and looked at a bloom from the bottom, it'll look the same way.
He's referring to algae blooms. You know, they're those green blobs in lakes and oceans. And they're teeming with bacteria. And incidentally, they grow and change shape just like the patches on Venus. But of course, scientists need more than shapes to go on. They need proof that bacteria like this could theoretically exist in Venus's clouds, which at first glance doesn't look all that inviting. They're not made of water ice like the clouds on Earth. Instead, they contain toxic sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid. But digging a little deeper, scientists found exactly what they were looking for in India. It's a special type of bacteria. This bacteria could withstand highly acidic environments and stay aloft in clouds on Earth. It's a big stretch to say that these bacteria could survive on Venus, but it's not hard to imagine how the similar environment in Venus's clouds might harbor some forms of life. After all, Venus wasn't always the pressurized oven that we know today, with surface temperatures hot enough to melt lead and pressures 90 times greater than the sea level on Earth. If you rewound about 2 billion years, patterns on Venus's surface suggest the planet once harbored vast oceans. And those may have spawned life in the early solar system. And perhaps that life found a safe haven in the cooler acidic clouds, long after Venus became the sauna from hell that we know today. Now, scientists aren't saying there's definitely life on Venus.
The number one choice right away should be something that's not biology. So for decades, it's been what are non or abiology or abiotic reasons that could explain these contrasts.
But as more non-biology explanations are ruled out, a biological answer still looms on the horizon.
Something in the atmosphere is perpetually in the clouds.
Ultimately, solving this mystery will require, you guessed it, a trip to Venus. But right now, NASA has set its sights on more distant water worlds like Europa and Enceladus. But, you know, maybe one day we will pop over next door and see if anyone's home. So, what are your burning questions about space? What would you say to a Venetian microorganism if you met them? Let us know in the comments below.